What is up, guys? And I am back bringing you guys today another dose of some Call of Duty Ghost. Now, if you guys are new to my channel, you know what to do. Hit the subscribe button if you guys like the Call of Duty content that I post. Make sure to hit the post notification to get my latest videos. And if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. It really helps the channel grow. Now, guys, today I'm going to teach you guys how to camp on the smallest map on Call of Duty Ghost, and that is Strike Zone. Let's get into the gameplay. Right now, I am back using my favorite gun, the M27 long machine gun. And you know how I do it, rocking with the thermal sight, incog, a silencer, two lethals, and the extra attachment perk. Right now, I'm going to show you guys a high trafficked area pretty much at the beginning of every map on Strike Zone. If you guys play this and you guys get a try hard team, most people are probably gonna come this way. So guys, the reason that I moved out of the way was because sometimes when enemies shoot at your teammates, sometimes the bullets can penetrate through the teammate and then kill me instead. Well, as well, not instead. So leaving the guy who killed my teammate with a double kill, because the bullets penetrated through my teammate and killed me. Now I want you guys to pay extra attention to where I'm camping, because this is one of the most high trafficked areas on the map. Right there by the hot dog guy, I don't know what that place is called. And there's the bush guys, you see them. And right there by the concession stand, right outside the kitchen door area, something like that. Now if you guys are playing against a tryhard clan or a tryhard team, that means that the players are going to be running around this map like crazy, because this map is the smallest map on Call of Duty Ghost. Now if you guys pay extra attention to where I'm camping on the middle, or in the middle of the map, and I'm vulnerable from three sides, which is the right, on my right hand side, right up there, and on my left hand side too. Now over there, my IED generated me a kill. And if you guys pay extra attention, the spawn just switched places. Now, what I would recommend you to do is roll with two IEDs. You just place one right there and you wait up until it gets you a kill. And then you place a second one right there on the very same spot, because people are predictable. Sometimes they'd like to run over their dead bodies to collect ammo, and I'm also guilty of that. So if you place an IED on top of their dead bodies, it would also generate you a kill. And guys, like I said in the previous video, camping takes a lot of patience, and which is something most people don't have. A lot of people on Call of Duty Ghost have ADHD once they get to this point of the map. They just want to run around into gun battles, and it doesn't work like that, because Strike Zone is a pretty small map and everybody likes rushing on this map. Nobody's going to expect a camper to camp on such a small map. So sometimes it's better to be unpredictable. Now time to release the Spartan Beast Jr. with the Riot Shield. Now guys, in this gameplay, I stayed in one spot. I gave you guys the definition of camping itself. I didn't change my camping routes, I didn't alter my camping techniques. I stayed in one spot because my teammates were basically flushing out all the other enemies, and that generated me enough kills. So if you guys are new to my channel, you know what to do. Hit the subscribe button, hit the post notification to get my latest videos, and if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. It really helps the channel grow. I'm out. Peace.